Hello everybody, this is Minecralix here, and in today's video I'm making a very interesting let's play. I'm so excited for this let's play. Basically, I downloaded a new game called Rising World, and this is probably one of the best games I've ever played. It's on Steam and it costs $14.99, and this is simply stunning. This is just an amazing game. It is so amazing. It's kind of like Minecraft, but there's no blocks, and the graphics are just simply epic. And in today's episode, I'm going to start a new Let's Play, and in this episode, I'm basically going to create a new vanilla world in Rising World, and then we're going to try to get to the edge of the map, so basically, edge of the map or bust. Now, some of you may say that this is a ripoff off of some other YouTuber's theories called, Farlands or Bust in Minecraft. However, I'm not actually ripping the idea off, although I did take the idea off this YouTuber. I am kind of changing it to the Rising World environment, and since I have not seen any other YouTubers attempt to get to the edge of the world in Rising World, I'm going to do that today. So we're going to go into single player right here, and we're going to make a new world. So now let's name this something probably like Edge of the World Survival. The seed's going to be completely randomized. I did not set the seed. You could randomize it a bit, like let's just make it right like this. So I'm going to put it to survival, and it's going to be a complete vanilla world, meaning that the world type will be normal. The ores will be high, which is the vanilla preset, what it's already set to. We're going to have caves enabled, the vegetation's enabled, and animals. We're not going to change anything here. This is all going to stay the same. This is the most vanilla world that you can expect, and now let's create the world and dive into the world of Rising World. Okay, now we are loading into the world, and we have spawned. This is our spawn area right over here, and oh my god, this looks so beautiful. Ever since the last update, they added sand, and this just looks simply amazing. Would you check that out? And oh my god, this is so amazing. Let's chop down some trees like we usually do. And some of you may notice that I'm kind of chopping the trees a bit differently than others do. I'm just kind of spamming it, because if you just press down like so, then it's going to chop slowly. However, if you kind of spam it, and if you time it just correctly, you can actually hit the tree much faster, and that way you can mine things much faster. This applies to everything from mining sand to mining ores to mining stone and pretty much anything. And wow, this is amazing. Now, I'd like to say that in this episode, we probably won't necessarily go anywhere really far, and the reason for that is because I plan on kind of getting accustomed with Rising World, and by that I mean that we're going to set up a small base for this day, and I'm going to spend the next episode or so kind of preparing for my big journey. And what I mean by that is I'm going to probably mine for some iron ore. I'm going to attempt to find some plants like right here. I'm gonna collect a bunch of wood. I'm gonna get all my crafting tables, all my crafting stations, how they're called in Rising World. I'm going to basically kind of get going, and then after that, that's when we're gonna go on the journey. Now, I'm not really sure how we're gonna get across big oceans like this. We'll probably have to craft some boat or something, but I don't know. I have not really looked at the Rising World wiki for a while now, so I'm not even sure if there is if there are craftable boats in Rising World like there are in Minecraft. But otherwise, we're just gonna kind of have to go along the coastline or something, or kind of go in the opposite direction if we do encounter some really large oceans. But hopefully there aren't oceans that are too large in Rising World like there are in Minecraft. The reason why I want to get iron going is because the reason why I want to get some type of iron or something, iron ore is because I'm planning on getting a bucket and a canteen so that I could fill the canteen with water, and then that way I could have water. Because many of you know who have played Rising World before that in Rising World you do not only have to eat food, but you also have to keep your thirst in check. And along with the most recent update, which is something like Alpha 0.7 or something, I don't really know the exact number of the version. Oh wow, that rolled really far away. Anyway, I don't really know the exact number of the update that was just released recently, but in that update in Rising World, they actually added more items, like they added a canteen for drinking water, and before you still had thirst, but you had to eat food, and then that's how you would replenish your thirst. And food like tomatoes and especially watermelons replenish the most thirst, and that was not very, and that wasn't really cool because it was very difficult to replenish your thirst, and I would have to eat watermelons for thirst rather than for hunger. And now, thankfully, in this update, they've added canteens and buckets to hold water, and they actually added water. They not only added canteens and buckets, they actually also added the water to the Rising World, because before, Rising World actually did not have any water. Like, the whole game did not have water. So now, thankfully, it's much more realistic, and it looks like they really did work for a very long time on adding water to Rising World, because it just looks stunning. The graphics in this game are so much better than practically any single game that I have seen. And even though the reviews on Steam aren't that great, I think the reviews on Rising World are mixed, or either they're positive. I don't really know. I don't really remember what the reviews are exactly, but many of the reviewers on Steam claim that Rising World is a very boring game and that there's nothing to do. But I really think that it's a really amazing game because just of the graphics, and there are so many items. Now, if you haven't played Rising World before and this is the first time that you're seeing Rising World, which is probably roughly about half of the people watching this video right now, then I'm gonna tell you that Rising World is an experience that any and every Minecrafter should have. Okay, let's kill this piggy. Oh, I just kind of rode on top of him. Now I'm also gonna try to collect as much food as I want. Oh, ribs? I've never saw that before. That usually doesn't spawn with pigs. Yeah, that's kind of weird. Every time I get 8 bacon, but I don't get ribs. That's very weird. Well, that's great because we might have even a larger food supply then. So like I was saying, Rising World, and in my opinion, Rising World is an experience that every single gamer should have. And the reason, not every single gamer, but at least every single Minecrafter should play Rising World once, because it has very similar mechanics to Minecraft. It's an open world survival game. Many people say that it's basically Minecraft just with better graphics. However, I really don't agree with that. Okay, we got that pig. Now let's see, are we gonna get some ribs from this pig this time? Oh my god. Oh, it's not even stackable. Wow, we're getting a lot of bacon here, that's for sure. We're gonna have to cook the bacon. And now, I am really switching topics very quickly, but the reason that I need to get iron is so I can cook bacon and so I can cook food. And to cook food, you're basically going to need a campfire and a special kind of iron grill thing, an iron cover thing over it. And to get the iron cover thing, you need iron, and you need to go and mine iron, and you need to make a furnace and get coal to smelt the iron. So unfortunately, I probably won't be able to set out on my large journey, at least in this episode. Most likely I will start my big journey in the next episode, just because I am a fairly skilled Rising World player. I have played Rising World for quite a time now, so I know the mechanics of the game quite well. I know exactly where to look for all the ores. I'm a fairly good miner now, and as you can see, I'm able to destroy the logs much faster than most players can. Oh, what's that? Oh, we got potato seedlings. Potato. Wow. We're also going to have to craft some more tools. Like, we're going to have to craft a tool called a scythe and I'm planning to craft some weapons. I'm planning to craft a sword, and all of that requires iron. So I'm going to have to go down underground, try to find some caves, and mine iron. And these In Rising World caves are absolutely beautiful. Oh, we got some cotton right there. That's nice. Oh, and we have these cows right here. Look much more realistic than in Minecraft, of course. So now our next step is to go and try to craft a crafting table. Well, it's mostly called a crafting bench here, at least in Rising World. And like I was saying before, I was talking about cutting down trees and other stuff. I think that Rising World is an experience that every Minecrafter should have, because Rising World is a very fun game, and in addition to that, Rising World kind of, especially, it's great, especially if you have played Minecraft for a long time, and you kind of want to get the Minecraft experience. I know that many Minecraft noobs are saying that, oh, I want to experience Minecraft like I was new again, I want to experience Minecraft like a noob. Many professional Minecrafters say that they want to go back to the good old days and kind of become an inexperienced player once more, because it is very fun to be an inexperienced player, because you really don't know what to expect. And in that case, it's very interesting to play Rising World, because in Rising World, you basically feel like a noob, which is really great, because it's kind of like the Minecraft experience, but all over again. It's really great. It's really amazing. Now, Rising World, unfortunately, does not have any much enemies yet. They don't have mobs in Rising World, just telling you that from now on. So, Rising World is really more resource-oriented, and if you look at right here, there's just a crazy amount of different crafts that you can make. You could preview it in the 3D view mode. And you could make trash cans. You could just make different colors of trash cans. You can make this type of trash can. You can make trash cans with a cover. You can make different grills. You can make a smoker. You can modify all of your items practically infinitely. And, well, not infinitely, but you can modify your items very much. And this is exactly what we need. We need a cooking grill. If we place the cooking grill underneath a campfire, which can be crafted even in your inventory, there are some things, like in Minecraft, that can be crafted inside your inventory. So basically, these are the things that can be crafted inside your inventory. You do not need a crafting table to craft these. There's not really much thing that you can craft without a crafting table. And actually, there are many different types of crafting tables, because if you can see right here, you could select the crafting stations, and first there's a workbench. This is the first crafting station that you need to craft, and there's a block bench, and then using the block bench, you can craft blocks. And basically, if you look, there's no blocks here, but eventually when we start to get more items, we're going to be able to craft blocks. So let me just break that to make it a bit more even. So I'm going to place it somewhere right over here. There we go. And you can practically place this anywhere. And there's this yellow bar that kind of moves along where when you place something. And this is the block bench. And oh my god, you can craft so many different types of blocks. I mean, just look at this, guys. This is amazing. This is... how could this not be cool? You can practically craft blocks like this. You can craft blocks like this. You can craft blocks like this. I don't even know if this is a block. You can craft blocks like this. You can craft pyramid blocks like this. You can craft just regular full blocks like this. You can craft slabs like this. You can craft cylinder blocks like this. You can craft half cylinder blocks like this. You can craft ramps like this. You can craft kind of like these half ramps, or I don't even have words to describe this. You could craft stuff like this. You could craft stairs like this. You could craft stairs without the backside like this. I don't even know what this is, and why would somebody need that? You can craft stairs like this without the thing right here, but it not being smooth. You can craft stairs like this, but with only one kind of section right here filled in, all of these empty. And you can craft one like this, where all of these are filled in, but only one is missing. And oh my god, there's just so many things that you can craft. Like, look at this, guys. You can craft, like, stone bricks. You can craft these type of stone bricks. You can craft sandstones. Oh, and actually, I think that this is a glitch. This is very funny. Look at this. I think this is a glitch because the texture was supposed to be here, but it's not. Yeah, the game is still in alpha mode, so it does have a few bugs, but none of the bugs are exactly. They don't really make the gaming experience too bad, because there are bugs in several games where that make the gaming experience very bad and negative. There are many kind of game-breaking glitches, but Rising World so far as I've played it, and according to Steam, I have played Rising World for about 19 or so hours. So according to... And yes, and there we go, we got a bit more blocks that don't have textures to them. But like I said, of all the times that I played Rising World, and I've played Rising World for a long time, I have not really found any game-breaking glitches, so don't be scared to try out and buy the game, because if you like Minecraft, you most likely won't be disappointed. And oh my god, there are so many different colors of plaster. Like, this is just unreal. Like, oh my god. And it's almost nighttime now, and wow, look at that sun, guys. This is just amazing. Oh, well, I'm not gonna try to hit him, because he'd probably kill me, so, yeah. Okay, so the next level is a saw bench, and for that, I need a bit more... Did he just laugh at me? No, I'm just kidding. Okay, so for a saw bench, I need 32 lumber, so I'll just go into my... crafting inventory, and in my inventory crafting, I'm not using any workbenches right now. I'm just using my inventory, so I'm going to make craft 32 lumber, and this requires 8 pieces of logs. So we just crafted 32 pieces of lumber, and then that way we can craft a saw bench. And basically, what a saw bench does is it's basically a thing that you can use to craft furniture, and oh my god, Rising World actually has furniture, like, it really does. It's just simply amazing, guys. The possibilities are endless in Rising World. But the thing that I have to do now is I'm probably most likely gonna go down into the mines. I'm going to go down, and this is kind of difficult to mine, because like you're seeing, I'm still using the glitch where I kinda, if I went like this, I'm gonna mine much slower, but instead I'm going like this. Now, Rising World, although the graphics are quite realistic... Wait, what? There's already an ore? Oh my god, that was very lucky. We got to an ore, like, straight away. In Rising World, even though the graphics are very beautiful and very realistic, some aspects of the game aren't as realistic, because, as you can see, the sand does not cave in like it does in Minecraft. You can place sand without it falling. There's not much gravity in Rising World. I don't know if they're gonna add that in the future, but so far there's not much gravity. So now what I'm gonna have to do is I'm going to have to craft a piece of log, and then from that I'm gonna craft some lumber. So we could craft 16 pieces of lumber. And then from that, we're going to craft a few torches, 16 torches and 16 torch mounts. And in Rising World, unlike in Minecraft, you cannot actually place torches on the ground. As you can see, if I place the torch in my inventory, I can actually use it. What? Okay, I'm going to take a screenshot of that since I'm on Steam. So as you see, I can actually, oh my god, I just can't get over this. Look at the sunrise. This is just amazing. So like I said before, I actually can use the torch inside my inventory to hold the torch in my inventory while I'm walking around. And oh my god, the graphics are so amazing. Oh my god, look at that water. And of course, if I walk into the water, it instantly kind of becomes unlit. The torch kind of becomes... extinguishes. As you can see, unfortunately, the game does not currently have, I don't know if they're gonna add this in the future, but the game doesn't have a meter of oxygen. So when you go underneath the any water, so if you go underneath this water or something, then you can run out of air, but there is no kind of gauge or there is no meter that shows if you are close to running out of air or not. So unfortunately, that's kind of a drawback. And if you look at that, I cannot place the torch on the ground, unlike in Minecraft. And to do that, you have to use a torch mount. And what a torch mount does is basically you can place a torch mount pretty much anywhere, and then on the torch mount, you can then place torches. And as you can see, unfortunately, the torches are not very bright. The torch actually seems much brighter. So if you can see right here, the torches, it seems much brighter when I'm holding it in my hand rather than when it's actually on the floor. But this game actually contains electronic means of lighting, so there are actually lamps, there's even a flashlight, and that's kind of late game stuff because you need a bunch of tungsten, and for lights you need a crafting station, which is called Workbench Tier 2, and this is basically a very advanced workbench made out of 32 iron plates, 32 iron rods, and 4 aluminum plates. Now I don't think that we're going to craft one of these crafting stations anytime soon because we're mostly going to be on the go. And we're always going to have a nomadic lifestyle. But if we find some ore, like, on top of the ground or something, or close to, or somewhere close to the ground level, then we're going to mine that ore, and hopefully we are going to find tungsten pretty much soon. And actually, tungsten, there's an ore called tungsten in this game. Tungsten actually, it's quite often occurring. It's a very, there's a lot of tungsten in this world. Tungsten isn't a rare ore in this game. Okay, now it's getting way too dark. And I have actually found a lot of tungsten in my other worlds, just like laying on the ground. And by that, I mean, practically I was just walking on, sorry about that, my mic disconnected for some reason, 1 second there. Oh my god, we got tungsten. And this is what I mean, guys, there's so much tungsten in this world. I mean, tungsten is so naturally occurring, it's a naturally occurring element. Well, I know, I mean, well, it's a naturally occurring ore in this game, like all ores are in this game, but tungsten is quite an often ore. There's a lot of tungsten in this world, it's a very commonly occurring ore. That's kind of the words that I was searching for. And because of that, we might start making, oh my god, there's tungsten ore in sand. Yeah, it is sometimes that tungsten ore gets encased in some sand, and this happens to many other ores like iron. Now, the hard part now is going to be getting out, but I'm just going to mine some of the resources here. And I'm also going to mine some of the stone just because I want to get some stone for our journey. And also because I need stone to basically do many things, and I'm gonna use the stone to craft stone blocks or plaster blocks. Well, practically every block, almost, like, well, except a few blocks, almost all blocks in this game are used, can be crafted from stone, so hopefully I'm gonna craft that. And now that we're getting deeper down, it's getting more dark, and hopefully we're gonna find more ores. Now, this game has many, many different ores. This game actually has silver ore, this game has gold ore, this game has, this game has mycelium ore. Oh my god! We got silver, guys! We got silver! So, practically, for some reason, this Rising World is just proving all of my statements right now, because I'm saying that Rising World has iron in it, and Rising World has silver in it, and, like, almost right after I said that Rising World has silver, then that's when I actually found silver, which is pretty cool. Now, silver in this game is quite useless, unfortunately. It is a rare element in this game, and it is quite a rare ore in this game, but it's quite difficult to detect, and it blends in with the rest of the rock very well. Like, this is not silver, but it kind of looks like silver, especially under the very bad lighting of the torches. It kind of looks like stone, and I would sometimes miss silver. And now we're kind of running out of water right now, which is kind of bad. If you look on the top down on the on the bottom right-hand side of my GUI, you could see kind of a knife and a fork. The knife and a fork represent how hungry I am, and the... So basically they represent how hungry I am, and the little bottle thingy represents how thirsty I am. So unfortunately ever since the new update, I have become much thirstier in Rising World, and now the characters in the player gets... The player can get much faster thirsty, so basically you get much thirstier, and that is unfortunate because I have not found any iron ore, unfortunately. And to craft a canteen, I'm going to have to find iron ore, and unfortunately I have not found any iron ore. I would have much more rather found iron ore instead of silver ore, because silver ore is completely useless. Nobody needs silver ore. It's really stupid. I really wish I had found something different than silver ore, but unfortunately I did find silver ore, so we're just gonna go step by step just down here, just an attempt to find some more ores, especially iron. Iron is exactly what we're searching for right now. That's kind of our goal. Now I am kind of running out of torches, but thankfully we have a lot of wood with us, and we have a lot of wood in this world in general, so thankfully we're not gonna run out of wood anytime soon. And since we're going to have a nomadic lifestyle, since we're going to basically go in one direction forever, I'm just going to go in one direction forever and ever and ever. And since we're gonna have a nomadic lifestyle, I don't think that we're going to have to plant any trees, so most likely we're just gonna have to find trees in the landscape, and then just kinda bulk up on wood where we can find it. So where we find the wood, that's where we're going to have to collect a lot of it, just in case if we go to a biome that doesn't have much wood. For example, biomes like mountainous biomes in Rising World, they don't really have much wood, and they actually have very, very little trees. They almost have no trees at all, which is very unfortunate. And because of that, if we are inside a mountainous biome and we're low on trees, that's going to be very bad. So that's why if we get to a biome like we are right now, and we're in a very nice biome, this is a plains biome, there's not too many mountains. There's not too many mountains in this biome, and since there are no mountains in this biome, there are many, many food sources. There are many, there's like tomatoes here, there are watermelons here, there's like... Oh, we found coal, so we're basically going to use this coal as fuel for our furnace when we smelt all of our ores, which is great. So I just have to bulk up on these ores for this time, and then as soon as I get enough ores, then that's when I'm going to step up on our journey, and hopefully we're going to have many ores with us, and we're going to have to carry everything in our inventory, so we don't want to stock up too much. Now... I just want to have the basic equipment, like equipment for, like the iron grills for cooking food, because most likely we're going to live on scavenging food. We're going to be scavengers, so we're going to try and find and scavenge some food, and to scavenge food, we're going to have to just find food in the biome that we are in. But if we are in biomes that do not have much food, we're going to have to pile up and stock up, like I said before. Oh wow, we're finding more ore. Let's hope that it's let's hope that it's iron. Oh, now unfortunately that's copper, but I think that's ore right there. Iron ore right there. Oh, we got iron. I'm so happy. We might now finally go and then craft a furnace so that we can smelt the iron ore into iron ingots, and then by and we're gonna use the iron ingots to make a grill. And since we're going to live off the land, what we're going to do is we're going to basically kill off all the animals that we see. And if we see any animals, that's when I'm going to kill them. And like I said before, the food in Rising World is much more nutritional when it is cooked. And the best way to cook food, especially if you're on the go, is to use a grill and a campfire. And to get a campfire going, and for us to actually... cook food on a campfire, we need a special iron grill, and to craft an iron grill, we need iron, and we need a special crafting table too, so you'll see what I mean when we come up there. And to craft to craft a grill, we need to make an anvil for working with iron. So to make an anvil, we're gonna need even more iron. So technically, I need about half a stack or so of iron before we can really get going. And oh my god, I'm totally running out of water. I'm going to have to eat some bacon. That's hopefully going to replenish our... Well, oh my god, this is bad. Oh, well, we're going to eat some tomatoes. Tomatoes. There you go. Tomatoes, they replenish much more thirst than meat does. And actually, some types of meat, especially if it is burnt meat, and believe me, you can burn meat in Rising World, they actually take away more thirst than they give. For example, in my first world in Rising World, and I have played Rising World already many times, I have already created some worlds in Rising World, I have actually burnt bacon before in Rising World, and when you burn bacon, you can still eat it, but what it basically does to you is when you eat it, it does not really give you as much nutritional value as regular cooked bacon would, and in addition to that, it actually decreases your thirst level. So eating burnt meat or bacon actually takes away thirst rather than give it to you. So yeah, that's that. My god, how big could this vein be? But thankfully I have my very great way of mining, and let me show you. This is what happens when you don't mine like that. This is much slower. Compare this. This is very slow. But if you time your hits exactly correctly, so if you notice, if I hit this and then I stop mining it, it still has the cracks, and then I can continue mining it so that it's kind of realistic. So what you have to do is you don't have to let the pickaxe bounce back, and you have to time it so that when you hit it, so that you can come back and hit it once more, and then kind of that way, that's how you can mine much faster. Now, I don't know if this is a glitch or this has been made by the developers just like that, but I am definitely going to exploit this because I definitely don't have time to mine all of these ores for a long time. We are running out of time, and I don't want to make this episode too boring, but like I want to remind you guys, this episode will be an episode of gathering resources. We're going to stay here for a day or two, maybe 2 days or so, depending on how long it takes us to get enough iron for an anvil and enough resources to craft anything like that. Yeah, we're gonna stay here until we can get enough resources, and by enough I mean more than enough, just in case, because leading the nomadic lifestyle that we will as soon as we start on our large journey, we will have to have many, many resources. And this really goes back to the idea that you need to really stock up. Basically, in case if you have a lot of resources, at which point right now I do have a lot of resources, you have to take advantage of that, and you have to gather the resources while you can, because there will always come a time when these resources become depleted, and that's when you actually need the resources. So that's kind of my philosophy, and because of that, I'm going to try as much as I can to gather the most resources I can on my first day, and I'm also going to attempt to do this on my nomadic lifestyle, during my nomadic lifestyle as well. Pretty much during this whole series, I'm going to try to collect as much resources as I can, and because of that, just in case, so that when I do not have access to resources, so that if I have an emergency situation with the resources, then I'll kind of have a soft cushion to kind of bail me out. And if you saw that right there, I just kind of created a little walkway up here, and it is quite difficult navigating Rising World because you have to, I do not have any ladders with me, or I don't have any blocks with me currently, so I'm going to do that and craft that. And also in addition to that, there's actually a glitch that if you place, a torch holder on a block, and then you break that block, you could get a floating torch, which is really cool. I don't know if that's going to be patched anytime soon. But now we're going to start collecting iron ore. Now let's hope that this iron ore vein is large enough, so that we might, let's hope that this, iron ore vein is as large as the copper vein. Let's see how much copper we have. Oh my god, we have like practically 2 stacks of copper. Now, I really hope that this is the same deal with the iron ore, because we could really use 2 stacks of iron right now. Now, like I said before, to get started, we need at least half a stack or so of iron, preferably a whole stack, so let's hope that we might get a stack from that. Now, we are kind of running out of thirst again, so let me just eat a bit more, another tomato. Okay, we ate that. Now, we are about... Now it's kind of light green, it's going to go down very quickly. Thirst goes down very quickly. And I think the reason for that is because we're inside, a desert biome because we're on the beach. So maybe the reason why we're inside kind of like, I don't really know if this is a desert biome or a beach biome, but there is definitely sand up there, so maybe that is the contributing factor why we're losing thirst so much. So now let's see. Oh, we got 32 iron ore. Not bad, not bad. But in reality, I would have really hoped that we've gotten more iron ore. Okay, now our inventory is almost completely filled up. Now I'm going to go back up to the surface, and wow, we've gone pretty deep down. Now I'm going to go back up to the surface, and hopefully it's already daytime up there. I'm just going to run up there. Up. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Okay, now for some reason I can't really get up there. And what I can do is actually in Rising World you can actually replenish these by kind of like placing, if you place them like this, you can kind of fill this area in, and that's what I'm going to do. I just fill this area in with rocks a bit. Okay, now we're on the surface. Oh, I forgot. Oh, yeah. Unfortunately, yeah, we did make this mess here, so let's just try and kind of, fill some of this area in, hopefully, so that we could get, access. Or what I could do is I could just mine myself up from the other side right here. Now I don't know why this is making a sound like I'm mining stone. Okay, now this is making a better sound. Okay, I don't know why is this making the sound again. Sometimes it makes the sound like I'm mining, rock or stone, and other times it makes the sound like I'm mining sand. I just guess it's just some glitches in the game, obviously. This is not, obviously this game is still in development, so don't really expect too much from this, but I actually think that this game is very great, and at its current stage, even as alpha, this game is way more than enough what I would ask for a great game. So now what we have to do is I'm going to basically craft some... Darn, our inventory is almost all filled up. What are we going to do? Oh my god, we got a cherry sapling? I didn't even know there's cherries in Rising World. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably... Oh wow, that looks juicy. Look at that. So I'm basically going to throw this out for a while until I craft some blocks. So I'm going to craft some plaster blocks. Let's just say we're going to craft... a stack of plaster blocks, so let's just go to 64, and you could change the count of it right here. You don't have to really enter anything in here, you could just kind of craft it like that, like, unlike in Minecraft where you do have to enter things, like, and by entering things, I mean, you have to kind of, inside the crafting table, you have to kind of, like, set the things in so that, like, you have to make the shape of an item so that you craft it. But in Rising World, you don't have to do that because all of the crafting recipes are already inside the crafting interface. So, okay, now we're placing some, plaster blocks right here. Now, I'm just gonna make a small platform right here. This is going to be our temporary base, and obviously in this type of Let's Play that I'm doing, where we're going to always lead a nomadic lifestyle, we're not really going to have any permanent bases, because the whole point of this Let's Play is to be really nomadic, so I really don't want to get into building bases too much, but at least for the first 2 days or so, I do want a small base built while I'm kind of gathering resources and stuff, and this is basically 64 blocks right here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my saw bench right here, so let's just kind of spin it around right here, and in Rising World, it's a bit difficult to lead a nomadic lifestyle because there's just so many different crafting cables that you need to craft things, so I'm most likely going to have a lot of wood, but obviously if we are in a plains biome and there's a lot of wood, that's not going to be an issue, but I did kind of chop down quite a bit of wood right there, so okay, now we have to eat some more tomatoes right there. So now what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to craft, I'm going to craft a smelting furnace. So for that I need 128 stone and 4 lumber, so let's go ahead and craft 4 lumber for my resources section. That only requires one piece of log, and thankfully I have more than enough stone for that. So, okay, now we got the, our furnace ready. So now this furnace is actually really, really large. I'm not going to waste space on it, so I'm just going to place it somewhere around right over here, I guess. So that would be a level, and it takes longer to place larger items. So right now you're going to hear a loud thump as it's finished, and there we go, you heard that thoo, kind of fell down or something. Okay, now we have to mine some of the sand under here just to make sure that we're able to get to it. And now let's go and craft some more plaster from, oh, we have to pick this up, yep. So now we have more inventory space now that we've got rid of some of the items. Now I'm going to have to craft some more plaster, probably like 10 or so blocks. And then that way I'm going to be able to kind of make sure that I have a good level. And I mean like a good area where I can actually reach. Where I can actually reach all the spaces in the furnace. This looks like a great area. And another thing that you have to do is you have to go to the right side right here. And there's this little kind of thing that opens. And it also has the sounds when it opens and closes. And what you need to do that is basically the fuel compartment. And to do that and to fill it up, you have to basically grab your coal right here. And this has to be coal. You can't use wood or anything else, as far as I'm sure. And to get coal, you do have to mine it. You can't actually smelt wood to get coal. They might add this in the future, but as of now, you cannot use anything other than mined coal for fuel. Basically, you right click right here, and this basically places and kind of smashes it, so this kind of fills the furnace up. Now, I'm going to get this to about 200, but I'm not going to fill this up any further, and the reason for that is because since we're leading a nomadic lifestyle, I do not want this to waste my precious coal on this single furnace, because once you have coal inside a furnace, you can't take it out. So, preferably, I'm not going to fill this up with too much coal, but since I have a lot of ore with me, I'm probably going to have to fill up quite a bit, because we have a few stacks of ore. So while that's smelting, what we can do is we can actually craft another smelting furnace. Although, I don't think that we're going to craft another smelting furnace, because most likely we're going to have to use our stone to craft blocks instead of smelting furnaces. So, well, I don't really know what I'm going to do as of now. I guess we just have to wait. Or we could go back into the mines. Or I could just kill this thing right here. Oh. Yeah, I don't really want to touch it, because, I mean, look at those horns right there. He could just kind of really... He could really hurt me. He could actually kill me, so, yeah. But one thing that I could do is I could actually go out into the ocean right there and just kind of observe the area underneath, so... So basically, this is how we can swim. Now, the visibility is not very good down here. I have not actually... Oh, wow. I haven't actually swum in Rising World before, like in oceans. And unfortunately, there is no meter that determines how much oxygen you have to breathe. So that's unfortunate, but... So apparently there's sand underneath here, so... Now, I don't really know how far this thing goes out, and I don't think I'm gonna really try, because this can go for a very far... this can go for a very long time. And most likely, I won't go into the direction of the ocean. I'll try to go in that direction, just because it's much easier to go in that direction, since there's more trees there, and just in general, it's a better environment to go through, and it's also more fun, too. But oh my god, the water looks so beautiful. This beach is so awesome. Okay, hopefully we have finished our smelting operation, but most likely we have not. Yeah, I think it needs to smelt more. Yep, and obviously it is still smelting. So what we can do now is we can kind of just go out and try to scavenge for food and stuff. Oh, we found a bit more tomatoes. We could use those tomatoes for replenishing our thirst. Now we can go out and find possibly some watermelons. The watermelons are great for replenishing thirst too. Okay, we got those watermelons. We got a bit more potatoes. Hopefully we'll eat that. Now, I'm not actually going to do farming in this Let's Play, most likely, because, like I said before, this type of nomadic lifestyle does not really account for farming. And since I probably won't have time to farm, and I won't be able to farm at all, because... Okay, hopefully we're going to get some beefsteak. Yeah. Raw beefsteak. This is very great food. So we're mostly going to rely on foods from animals, and we're not going to farm much. But when we do actually eat non-animal products like tomatoes, we're gonna get them from wild plants, like I just did. I'm not gonna plant the plants. I'm not gonna take a scythe and attempt to get the seedlings from it and attempt to farm them. What I'm gonna do is I'm most likely gonna just kind of get the tomatoes out off there and just kind of continue on and try to find more plants that I can rip off. So hopefully, yeah. Now, I really should have placed iron inside here before copper, because I do not really need copper, but I will most likely convert all of these ores into ingots while I have the furnace right here. So, yeah. That's that. I really don't know what to do now. I might possibly go down and try to mine more, but I don't know. So, this is our entrance right here, not that right there, so... let's try to go down and find some more. Okay, where is our... Just kind of got confused there for a while. Oh, there we go, yeah. Okay, now what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to craft some more torches to light up the tunnel. Now I'm going to dig further deep down. Hopefully we could get really, really deep down, because that's where the really good ores start to occur. Now we still have some coal here that we didn't... That we still have and that we still did not mine. So hopefully we're gonna mine that out right here. So right now I'm just kinda thinking, how are we gonna get, how are we gonna continue this? Well, the only thing that I could do is I could place some type of stairs to go down there, I guess, so... Hopefully when I come down here, I'm going to place stairs that are going to go down, and then off down there, I'm going to continue. So I'm going to have stairs that kind of go from right there, down right here, and then I'm going to continue my tunnel going downwards right there in hopes of finding more ores. And of course, the best ores occur the deepest down, so while we are already deep down enough, so that's when I'm going to go even deeper, just in hopes of finding better ore. Although we don't really need any gold or anything like that, because gold is mostly used for ore detectors, and in Rising World, there's a thing called an ore detector. Now, I can't show you what it looks like, because it requires, an ore detector requires you to have, workbench tier 2 to craft it, so, I won't be able to even show you how it looks like in the crafting inventory, but... It's basically, the ore detector is basically, an item, basically this thing that you can kind of, hold in your hand, and it basically beeps when you find ore, and you can preset it to beep for certain ores, or you can just do it for all ores, and wow, we got our nice copper ingots there, so we'll just collect that, and wow, that didn't take too long. And some of you are probably asking me, well, how can you skip the night? Well, there are actually beds in Rising World. You can actually sleep in Rising World. So, okay, right now I'm going to get my iron ore, which I have not much of. Now, let's hope that we're going to... Oh, we're not going to fit all this iron ore in, because it only accommodates 24 pieces of ore to be smelted at once. It doesn't account 32, so we'll still have some ore. Yep, there we go, 8 ore left over. So now we're going to smelt all of these ores and then just wait for quite a long time until they're all smelted. So like I was saying, you can actually sleep in Rising World, and to do that, all you have to do is you have to craft this thing called... You can actually craft this thing called a small shelter. You probably noticed that. And all you need is 32 sticks. So now what I'm probably going to do is... Now, although I do want to have a nomadic lifestyle, I'll most likely have to craft just one chest just so I could get my inventory organized. So let's see. This requires 16 lumber. So I'm just going to go to my resources. And let me just craft 16 lumber from there. So there we go. That's going to require 4 pieces of log. So... there we go, 16 pieces there, and now we're going to craft, now we're going to craft the chest, and I'm going to, you can vary the different looks of the chest, you can make it like this, you can make it like this. What I think I'm going to do is I think I'm going to probably make one, I'm probably going to make it like this. Yeah, this looks really nice. What do you mean there is no more item? Oh, yeah, because... yeah, that's unfortunate. So I'm just going to throw this thing out, and I love how natural these things look. I mean, look, that kind of really slid down naturally. That is amazing. The graphics in this game are really something. Okay, so let me craft that, and yep, there we go. We got a chest going, so I'm going to place the chest somewhere right over here. Just kind of spin it like this, and then there we go, old chest. And it actually has 2 pages, so if you notice, I place this right here, and then if I go to the second page... this is basically has 2 of these. So a chest in Rising World holds a lot of things. And what I'm gonna put here, I'm just gonna put here all of the food that I have. Wow, that looks like a savory beefsteak there. So I'm gonna basically put all of the food that I have over there, and a lot of excess all of these saplings that I have that I'm hopefully gonna accommodate for in my inventory. All of these logs, I'm probably going to craft them back into different items so that I could compress my inventory. And by that I mean I might craft them into lumber or something so I could compress my inventory down. All of this stone I'll most likely craft it into blocks, and I will most likely leave some of the blocks right here. And wow, just saw that, that's glitched out there. Oh, I accidentally opened the console. So yeah, that's a weird sound that it makes, to be honest. So yeah, well, now all we can do is we can probably go and get some more wood. But on the other hand, I don't think that we have... I think that we have enough wood. Although I would probably like a bit more birch logs, on the other hand. And this cotton that we have here, we can probably craft a loom so we can weave cloth. So I could turn this cotton into cloth, and cloth is useful for band-aids and stuff like that. And yeah, there are band-aids in this game, so in case I get hurt or something, I'm gonna need band-aids. And to get band-aids, I need cloth, and to get cloth, I need cotton, and to weave cloth out of cotton, I need a loom. So let me go ahead and craft 16 lumber from my inventory right here. So let's just craft 16 lumber. That's only 4 pieces of log. That's not much. And then now let's craft a loom. I have actually never crafted a loom in this game before. So this is going to be a new thing for me. Now, I really don't know where we're going to place this. Probably going to... Now, I don't really know which direction it's supposed to be used from, but I'm probably mostly going to place it somewhere right over here. And then there we go. So, yep, we're going to have the loom right over here, and that way we have access to all of our other crafting tables. Oh, hemp leaves, hemp fibers. Oh, wow, that's a nice tent. Oh, you can even vary it. I never even knew these items existed in the game. It's amazing. There's just so many different cool things that you can do. But of course, probably of all of the crafting tables and the crafting stations in the game, the loom is probably the least useful because you can craft only 3 items with it. Although it is still quite useful because it's the only way you can turn cloth into, cotton to cloth. So, okay, now hopefully we're going to craft 3 cloth, and then there we go, we got 3 cloth. Now, I have never actually used cloth in this game before, so let me just look at how it's used, and wow, this is pretty cool. We got some nice cloth there. And if you see right here, if you go to this crafting table and go to medical, you can create a leg splint. Oh, there's bone fractures. Now, I have never actually gotten bone fractures in this game before, as far as I'm concerned. But you can actually use these band-aids to stop bleeding, so... in addition to that, I think that you can also craft beds using cloth. I'm not really sure where that is. Let's see, miscellaneous, medical... Oh, I'm pretty sure that requires you to use the saw bench, so... Oh, bathroom. Yeah, and you can actually have a toilet. Now, I really don't know what you can do with a toilet, but you need iron plates to craft it, so I'm not going to craft that in this Let's Play, because obviously we're always going to be on the move. I'm not going to have a base to put this in. So now it looks like I have some beds right here. Okay, wow, there's a bunk bed. Looks not very comfortable, but probably better than sleeping on the floor. It's pretty nice. But like we see right here, this requires at least 16 cloth for the smallest bed. But we only have 3 cloth, so I'm probably going to go ahead and craft 3 band-aids. Oh, actually 12 band-aids. Yeah, so I'm going to craft 12 band-aids, and if we ever get a fracture or start bleeding or something, that's where I'm going to go for relief. Oh, that looks really cool. Okay, wow, that's nice. Collecting our iron ingots, which is great. Now I'm going to place some more iron ingots. No, not iron ingots, but I'm going to place some more iron ore in there so that I could finally craft what I need. Oh, I didn't collect one right there. And then the rest, I'm just going to fill this in with something like copper or something, just so I wouldn't waste the spaces. And you can actually see a bit difference between the ores. Like, the copper ore looks a bit more, if you can look at that, the copper ore looks much kind of oranger than the iron ore. The iron ore looks a bit yellower than the copper ore, so that's the distinct difference with it. And now let's take a look at how much fuel we have left. Okay, now looks like this could use just one more piece of coal, so hopefully this is not too much. Now, we don't have too much in, but, this is going to sustain enough of the, smelting that we need, so, yeah. My god, this thing just won't leave. Now, I know this episode has probably been quite boring for you, but, unfortunately I can't do anything about that, because this is just the type of episode that we're doing, because... In this episode, we have to kind of get accustomed, and we have to gather enough resources so that we can try to get to the edge of the world. Now, as far as I'm concerned, I will most likely continue this episode series for as long as I can. I might even get to episode 500 if I can, so yeah, I'll try to do this episode, I'll try to... film these episodes practically until I die, because I really, really, really want to get to the edge of the map. Now, I don't really know much about the edge of the map in Rising World. This game is supposed to be infinite, but like all other world maps, like Minecraft, it is technically not infinite. Although it is procedurally generated, there is a frontier, kind of like a place where it kind of starts glitching out, kind of like the far lands in Minecraft, where you cannot really go further. So but in Minecraft, to get to the far lands or to get to the edge of the map, it would require you to walk for a few months without stopping. So if you think about this, if you're walking forward for several months 24/7 without stopping, that's how long it's going to take you to walk to the edge of the map in Minecraft. Now, I really don't know how it is for Rising World. I don't even know what kind of edge of the map is there even in Rising World, but anyway, this makes this even the more interesting, because I don't really know what to expect from the edge of the world, so hopefully I will someday reach the edge of the world in Rising World, before I die, hopefully, yeah. Okay, now, can we craft an anvil? So, like I said before, I have to craft an anvil so I can craft, iron plates, and I need iron plates and iron rods to craft, basically a grill that's going to be used for cooking meat. And I do really need to cook the meat, because it increases the efficiency of and the nutrient capacity of the foods. So now if we look up right here, crafting stations, and go to anvil, here we have 24 iron ingots, and we have exactly 24 iron ingots. So we just wasted all of our 24 iron ingots. Actually, on the other hand, I wouldn't say that we wasted it. We kind of used it. We ran out of all of our iron ingots, but it went to a good cause because now we have an anvil. So thankfully, we can now craft an iron plate, and now we can craft a canteen and all of the good stuff. Now, if you look right here into components, right here, first I have to craft an iron plate, which is used for both the canteen and for the grill. But and then after that, I'm going to go into this crafting station. And then go into my miscellaneous, or is it, into my cooking grill, and then I need one iron plate and 8 iron rods. And then I'm also going to craft, I kind of forgot where it is. Oh, there we go. And I'm also going to craft a canteen, which also requires one iron plate. So hopefully we're going to have enough iron to craft both a canteen and the grill, so that way we're going to be able to have a good nomadic lifestyle when we're on the go. So, yeah. Okay, now let's look at that. So, we have a small shelter right here. We're going to craft it using 32 sticks because it's almost nighttime. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. Oh my god. Okay, so we go into our crafting interface right here. Now, let's craft some logs. Let's just craft 4 logs. Now let's craft some more sticks. Okay, now we have only 16 sticks. Now let's just craft 4 more lumber because we need 16 more sticks. So to basically create one shelter, to create one small shelter requires 2 logs. So now that we got the shelter, you can place it pretty much anywhere. I'm going to place it somewhere right over here. And now that we got that placed, I cannot remove it now. And then if I press F, I could sleep. So, yeah. Hopefully by the end of this episode, we will have all of the required materials we need in order to set off on our great journey that will probably last almost forever, as it seems to me. Because as much as this world is infinite, I can say that this let's play will last forever, and I'm just probably gonna go down here and try to find more iron just in case. And by saying that this let's play will last forever, I mean that, oh yeah, I forgot, we have to get ladders and some ladders or stairs to get down there. And by saying that this let's play will last forever, I do not literally mean that it will last forever, because, you know, in reality, nothing can last forever. But as much as this world is infinite, because the developers claim the world is infinite, like they do in Minecraft. However, in reality, the world is not really infinite. It's just really, really large. So, much like I claim that this Let's Play series will be infinite. My god, this is so beautiful. So much like I claim, oh, finally. Okay, I'll shut that off. Now we're gonna have to use all these iron ingots right here to craft all of the stuff that we need to do. And then after that, I'm going to cook all of my food that I have, all of my meat that I have, all my animal products that I have. And then after that, we can set out on our journey. So that's my plan. Okay, now we're probably gonna fill this in with a bit more copper ore, just because I wanna convert all this ore into ingots, just because I probably won't have access to a smelting furnace in a long time. Now, when I am on my journey, I will stop from time to time to gather more resources, depending on how resource stressed I am. So most likely, hopefully, I won't have to stop and craft a smelting furnace. But if I do, then that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to stop for no longer than one night. So that's going to be my policy. I'm going to try to be on move, and every single night I'm going to stay at a different place, except these few nights. Like right now, when I'm collecting resources, I have stayed here for several nights already. So that's just the one exception. That's when I'm starting up. So okay, now we have to probably eat another tomato so we can replenish our thirst. And I really hope that soon that we're going to be able to craft a canteen. We're actually going to be able to craft a canteen practically like right now. So Let's craft an iron plate. Canteen is our first order of business because that's what we need. And then there we go. Here's our canteen. So now let's go and try to fill it up from the ocean over there. And I'm not really sure if the developers have added this, but obviously in real life you cannot drink water from an ocean, but let's see if it's possible. You cannot fill this into your bottle. Oh, they actually added it. You can't fill bottles with salt water because this is the ocean. Oh, wow. That's really nice. This game is even more realistic than I thought. So, hopefully we're going to have to go and find some type of lake somewhere. So, that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to just run somewhere and try to attempt to find some type of lake or somewhere to fill my canteen up while my copper ore is being smelted. I don't really know. Why is there this random hill up there? I really don't know what that is. Now, hopefully that's a lake over there, and that does kind of look like one. Oh, we got a pig there, so that means some more bacon for us. Unfortunately, this is not not what I was expecting it to be, so... Wow, I killed that pretty fast. I used my fast kill technique like I usually do by the same... And by that, I mean my fast mine technique, and by that, I mean like this. This is much faster than going like this. That's also how I killed the pig. I just kind of spammed it like I usually do. So now let's hope we can spam and ambush this pig too. Okay, that one took a bit longer to kill, but we killed that one pretty quickly too. So now we have 16 more bacon, so that's great. Now let's hide its body once more. Let it disappear into the distance. Okay, now our search for a lake is still in action. I still have not found any lakes. Oh, I'm gonna grab that. We need more cotton. Wow, there's a lot of cotton here for some reason. So basically, this is how I'm going to grab all of my resources. I'm going to just kind of go around. Oh my god. Strawberries. Oh my god. Wow, we're getting more resources than I was expecting. We did definitely have a great spawn there because we have all these awesome resources. Let's definitely try not to really get too far from our base because I don't want to like lose our base, hopefully, because then that would suck. Okay, now let's collect a bit more tomatoes. Okay, now I do not see any lakes in the distance. Oh, there we go. There's a lake over there. How did I notice that? That's great. I think I saw a pumpkin there or something. I don't know. Or there was something orange here, definitely. Oh, I probably mistaken that for the flowers right here, so. Oh my god. This is so amazing. Let's fill our canteen. Let's drink from it, and let's fill it up once more. And oh my god, we have some... Is that iron ore or what? Oh, let's just study the different water mechanics of Rising World because it's very interesting how the water works here. If you look at that, the water kind of stays. It's kind of like a water wall. The water mechanics aren't exactly the best because if it was realistic, this water would have kind of flooded it. And if you can see those kind of weird squares right there, which is kind of weird. So, yeah, it's not the best water mechanics, but obviously this game is still in alpha, so can't really expect too much from it. So hopefully we got even more iron ore, so now that we have like 14 more ore, so that's going to be able, so we're going to be able to craft even more items, so yeah. And I don't really know if I do place the grill onto a campfire and then I want to move the grill, then would I have to craft a new grill or would I be able to... Oh, I think there's potatoes there. Yep, there we go. Or would I have to, like, craft another grill to cook more food? Because it would probably suck if I wasn't able to mine the grill and then move it on with me, so... Okay, that's still smelting over there, so now let's see. We got our canteen filled, which is great. Okay, let's see. 7 iron ingots enough to make a grill, so I'm pretty sure it is. So let's see, to make a grill, we go into miscellaneous. And then we got that cooker grill. So we need one iron plate and 8 iron rods. So let me craft one iron plate. Let's see. Okay, we have enough items. We have enough place in my inventory to craft this. Okay, now we got one iron plate. And then after that, I'm going to go to the iron rod. And to craft an iron rod, I need an iron plate. So let's see. We got four right there. And how much do we need again? Let me just double check just to make sure. While that's smelting, I'm gonna craft this. Okay, we need 8 iron rods. So, but now we're getting, right now we have 4. So that means one smoker grill requires us to use 3 iron ingots. That's not too bad. So let me just craft one more. There are very iron excessive crafts in this game in Rising World, especially when you get into electronics, and especially when you get into crafting like bulbs and stuff like that. That requires a lot of iron to craft. Okay, now we got the cooker grill right here, and as you can see, there we go, that's the cooker grill right here. Material 0, I don't really know what that means, but okay, shut our furnace down. Let's collect all of our copper ingots from right over here. Now, there is still some crackling while it's still hot, and I'm amazed that you're able to grab the... I'm still amazed that you're able to grab the copper ingots just with your fingers, even though they're, like, practically 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. In reality, you would not have been able to grab all of these ingots right after they've been smelted. You would have probably... In real life, you would have to wait, like, something like... 6 hours or so for the iron to cool to grab it. But in Rising World, of course, this isn't real life, so you can just grab the iron ingots or the copper ingots right after they've been smelted. So yeah, that's that. Okay, now we got that copper ore. We still have a lot of copper to smelt. Most likely I will do most of the smelting off camera in the middle of this episode and the next episode, because by the start of the next episode, or at least by the middle of the next episode, I want to get going. Now, I know that this episode has been probably very, very long for you guys, and I apologize for that. The reason for that is because I really want to get started in one episode, and what I mean by that is that I want to get started on this let's play in just one episode. I don't want to get started in several episodes. I want this to be a quick thing, because this let's play is about getting to the edge of the world. It's not about gathering resources and stuff like that. So yeah, okay, now let's go into crafting and craft a fireplace. Oh wow, we already have all that. Now that requires 9 stone and 1 piece of log, which looks like we already have all of those. Oh, now we don't have any logs now, which is great. Okay, now let's place a fire pit somewhere. Now maybe we're going to have to create a larger platform so we could place it somewhere right over here. Okay, now we ran out of blocks, so hopefully we're going to go back and craft some more plaster. Oh yeah, here's my block crafting bench. So let's just craft some 32 or probably 16. There we go, I crafted 32 blocks right here. Now let's just replace all this stone right here. Let's kind of place all of these right over here. Let me just mine some of the wood right here. No, I mean not wood, but sand right here, just so I could clear some of this area off. Okay, now I'm probably gonna place my fireplace right over here. So there we go. Nice. That's all now lit up. And then after that, I'm going to place this cooking grill up here. There we go. Now it's ready to cook some food for us, which is great. Although this is going to it's not the exactly most efficient thing to cook food, but it gets the job done pretty well in my opinion. And let's just try to place these as tightly as we can, just so we can really conserve space on the grill, since there isn't really much space on the grill. We might be able to go for another row right over here. And then there we go. So yeah, sooner or later, we're going to have all of these cooked. but I'll have to make sure that they don't get overcooked, because it's going to really suck if all of these are burnt up, because I have so many of them on them, and I really cannot afford to lose them all. Although, on the other hand, I really don't know how we're going to place all of this in our inventory, because I might have to drop some stone or some logs, just because we really don't have enough inventory space for all of these things that we currently have. So, yeah. Now, I guess that on this note, I'm going to end this episode off camera. As far as off camera work goes, I'm most likely going to smelt all of the remaining copper that I have. I'm going to cook all of the meat, all of the bacon, all of the beefsteak, all of the ribs that we have. I'm not really gonna do any more mining as far as I'm concerned. I do not need to collect any more resources as far as iron or copper or tungsten goes. I have all of that. Okay, actually, by the way, where did our tungsten go? We had tungsten. I'm sure we had tungsten. I really don't know where it went. Oh, there we go. Yeah, our tungsten here. So I'm going to smelt our tungsten. I'm going to smelt all of our copper. I'm going to cook all of the meat, all the bacon, all the ribs. Yeah, that's it. So hopefully as soon as we start the next episode, I'm going to be able to head out on the really, really amazing journey that will last probably years, if not several years. So I actually probably meant to say it's probably going to last months, if not years. So depending on how devoted I am to this Let's Play might last as few as several weeks, depending if on how bored I get with this Let's Play, or if I'm really, really into it, I might actually reach the end of the world, in which case it will probably take me like several years of walking to... several years of making Let's Plays like this, of walking and trying to find the edge of the world, because the YouTuber that made Farlands or Bust in Minecraft, he's been walking to the edge of the world since something like 2010 or 2011, and now that it's 2017, soon he's gonna be walking for about 6 or so years, and oh, as you can see, now that got cooked, and now as soon as that has happened, now the rest of these should get cooked as well, and notice how it turned color, and there we go, now that turned color, now we're just gonna have to wait for the last one to turn that yellowy tinge, so, and then after that, I'm gonna be able to collect it. Actually, I'm gonna collect these right now. Okay, so we got cooked bacon now, which is great. Now, unfortunately, this bacon only stacks up to 16, which is quite unfortunate, because I would really wish that it could stack to 64. That way, it would not take up as much space in my inventory as it currently does. Yeah, it is what it is. So, let me just get some more bacon from my chest right over here and just place it right here. I really hope that this episode has been interesting for you guys. I really want to make these episodes interesting, and if you want me to do something, like if you want me to talk more, or if you want me to talk less, or if you want me to talk about other things, or just basically if you want me to do something different, then just please don't hesitate to ask me. I'd be happy to accommodate that. I want to make these Let's Plays interesting for you. I'm just going to take a screenshot really quick for Steam, just because I like taking screenshots on Steam. Okay, now we got all of our iron ingots crafted up, so, okay, there we go, 16 iron ingots, okay, actually we have 2 more iron right there, so that's great. Okay, now all of the copper has now gone into my other slot, and the reason for that is because now I have 64 copper ingots in this slot, so it kind of went to the other slot, so okay, now we're gonna place some more copper here. Oh my god, we have so much copper. We only found like one vein of copper, and we already got like practically a stack of copper. Actually, a stack and practically like 2 stacks of... Oh, there's a piece of iron there. We practically got like 2 stacks of copper just from one vein of copper, which is quite unfortunate, because it's going to take up a lot of my inventory, and I really do not want to throw away copper. Even though it's useless, I still won't throw it away, because most likely won't have much access to copper for a while now. I would have much rather had a 2 stack vein of iron instead of copper, but we did get copper instead of iron, so yeah. and I'm gonna smelt all of the tungsten and stuff. So, yeah, thank you very much for watching. This was Minecraftlix, and I'm out. See you all in the next video.